here, I'm Yara Chuya, and welcome back to my channel. I've been gone for so long because it took me a long time to renovate my kitchen, but here it is, I'm making a video about it. The transformation is pretty drastic and I didn't even realize it would look this good. Personally, I think it looks amazing. I mean, you'll be the judge of it, but I had so much fun making it, and let me tell you, this whole transformation is perfect for anyone who runs their apartment. Let's get started. What a drastic change. I'm looking at the footage right now and I'm like, wow, I cannot believe that was the kitchen before. Let me just go back a few months ago when we were looking at apartments. The reason why I did not like this apartment is because of the kitchen. I felt like the kitchen was missing something. Like, it did not want to make me cook. So I don't even know where to start and how am I gonna do this, but I hope it's going to make sense to you guys. All right, so the first thing we did was to cover the whole cabinet. I did not like the color yellow. So I went ahead and bought some black peel and stick, and let me tell you that those ones are pretty good quality. We're gonna talk about quality in a little bit because I had a few problems. But this one, the one that we use for the cabinets, are perfect. It's smooth, it was easy to apply. Even though our kitchen is a little bit small compared to our old kitchen, like in our old apartment, it took us a while, you guys, to cover every inch of this kitchen to be all black. So I did not want to see that yellow, so even on the corner, I made sure I took the extra time to cut it to size and then stick it on it. I must say that that little change transformed the whole kitchen. I feel like that's the biggest transformation.
Alright, yeah, so halfway through the work, we realized that we didn't have enough rolls, so I went ahead and bought 3 more, and hopefully this is gonna be enough.
Chose black is, okay, if you guys look at my Instagram feed, everything is like bright and airy, and I feel like I like cream and white colors and just like something that is airy. But the counter was already black, so I knew for a fact that I did not want to put a peel and stick on the counter. So I was like, okay, what's going to look good with this counter? I just have to work around it. And I was like, let me just do an all black kitchen. It's such a statement and it's so beautiful because it's just a little corner and it's all black. So I had to play with a little bit of texture. So for the backsplash, I decided to do the subway tile. So I was so scared that the kitchen would look smaller than it looks because everything is gonna be black. So I ordered white subway tiles, like the peel and stick, of course, because I'm not gonna put real tiles on here. It's a rental, so I'm not gonna spend that much money on it. But let me tell you that the white peel and stick was so much better quality than the black. The last minute I decided to do black because I feel like it's just a statement. May as well go all the way. So I will link the white ones down below if you guys are interested in like transforming your kitchen or even your bathroom. I think the white ones are perfect for bathrooms. But the black one, I will not link them down below because the quality is questionable. It looks good from afar, but it doesn't stick. It took me so long to just hold it with my fingers, and sometimes the corner kind of lift up a little bit, so the next day I kind of have to push it with my fingers. So yeah, I don't want you guys to get bad quality stuff, like the backsplash that I have right here is not it. But the black elastic for the cabinets are perfect. Those ones I definitely recommend. Alright, what else can I tell you guys about this beautiful kitchen? Let's talk about the knobs. So I did not want to change the knobs because I feel like that would be extra cost for no reason. So as you guys can see, there's quite a lot of silver, so like all the appliances are silver and the knobs are silver as well. So I was like, I'm still gonna get silver knobs. I'm just gonna keep those ones. So yeah, that saved a little bit on the cost. A scam is calling my phone. Decline. Now let's talk about the decoration. Ah, so fun. Please don't judge me in this video because this is my first like style in the kitchen. Like I've never had a kitchen that I was excited for to style. So it took me a lot of Pinterest screenshots, and here's what I came up with. So since the color is black, I was thinking what else could I incorporate in it so it doesn't look just like a flat block of color. So for that, I decided to add few wood items whenever I was able to do that. So for example, those wooden spools right there, I think they composite the black pretty nicely. And I also got wood canisters. So the bottom is glass and the top is wood. I got a few of them from Amazon and I got a few of them from Target. So the large ones are from Target, and I think those ones fit a lot of stuff such as like sugar, flour. And then the smaller ones, the skinnier ones, can fit pasta. I just had fun with it. So ideally, I was looking for a practical decoration. You know what I mean? Like something that I could use as a decoration, but also use as a storage or used for another purpose. And I think those canisters are perfect. I was able to store all my dry goods, but yet it looks so good, like all together. I actually placed most of them on top of the kitchen, and it is pretty high, so I will not be able to reach them, but yet I try not to use those items quite often. Try not to add sugar in my food anymore, because here in America, the food is already so sugary, we don't need to add extra sugar. And I try not to bake, guys, like actual cake and stuff like that. So whenever I'm going to bake, that's when I'm like, okay, I'm gonna take the flour down. But for now, I just like to leave them up there. It's pretty to look at, and yet I know that I have it there just in case I need it. For the stuff that I'm actually going to use and eat, such as a lot of nuts, like walnut and cashews. Those ones, I place them in smaller containers so I can just place it like on the open shelves, and then I can actually eat it, use it, refill it easily. What else? My boyfriend and I, we drink quite a lot of tea, probably drink 3 cups a day, and he drinks coffee every day. So we decided to switch our water boiler, and it's a really cool one because you can see the water temperature and you can control how hot you want it. A really cool piece, I love it. I use it every day. Decoration is pretty easy. I basically went to Target and Home Goods, and I just got there some of the essentials, such as like the spoon holder. The black one is from Target, and then I got the black candle from Home Goods. Oh, when I found this black candle, I was so happy because it smells good and yet it's so beautiful and it's black. So I like to place that candle right in the corner right here and just burn it, and I feel good around the house. Oh yeah. I think the kitchen is definitely coming together, but now let's talk about the open shelf. I really wanted an open shelf. I think it's a nice way to just display the dishes, and I think it's just a nice touch. So it is doable for my boyfriend and I to have an open shelf because there's only two of us, so we don't need much stuff. But also I've came to a point that I told myself I do not want to hoard anymore. So when we came to this apartment, there were some dishes that we didn't use at all, like throughout the year. So I just let them go. And then I also got new ones that I think I'm going to use quite often, like almost everyday pieces. So I did get some black plates from Target. And let me tell you, they're so aesthetically pleasing. They're so beautiful. And I think that's just perfect for him and I to use on an everyday basis. Okay, we have to talk about how I place things, but you guys cannot judge me too much because like I'm new to this, but I got too excited. So I just move things around. I try to see what looks good where. But essentially the first row, the bottom row, the one that is closest to me, is what we use every single day. So for example, I placed our everyday plates there. I placed our cups because I told you guys we drink like 3 cups of tea every single day. So I placed the mugs, the plates, the water glass, and more plates, the ones that we switch up often. And then on the second row, I placed the ones that we use often, but not every day. So like the salad bowl, wine glasses, more plates. And then on the highest one, I place some items that I use rarely, like champagne glasses, shot glasses. What else did I place there? Some random bowls, some extra bowls. Now, when I looked at the price of kitchen books, they were so expensive. I could not stack a few of them because that would be like too much. So what I did is I went to the thrift store and I went to a specific bookstore. So I found so many beautiful books that are aesthetically pleasing. Here's the thing, yes, it's cool to have like kitchen books, but how often are you going to read it? For me, I got it because it's beautiful to see it. Also, when I follow recipes, I can literally just go online and then just find it online. But I think it's very warm and inviting to have books in the kitchen. But what I want to show you guys is you want to take off the cover, because usually the cover has the person's picture on it, or it has too much writing and the color is funky. So I took the cover and then I just kept the book itself. So essentially I was just looking for black, beige, brown, white books, and I found them and I was so happy. There are some that are so beautiful. Let me show you guys some of them. Alright, this is some of them. So this one is Pie and Tart. Like, you know, I told you guys I don't bake much, but when I bake, maybe I will like use this book. But look how beautiful. Even the inside is so beautiful. Oh, wow. But especially the outside is so pleasing to the eyes. I got another one like this one that says cake on it. So it's all the way up there. And look, this one is called The Good Housekeeping Illustrated Cookbook. And then the font is so pretty, the color is so appetizing, like I feel like it's just warm and inviting. But yeah, this is a really, really good book. Like this, I'm actually going to read. So that's why I placed this one right on the bottom, so I don't have to reach for it all the time. I must say, those are amazing finds. The price of all of my books combined is the price of one new book. How crazy is that? I did get one new book, but just one, from Target. And I think it's just like really nice with all the books, so that's why I got it. All right, we're almost done with the kitchen makeover, but I was looking at it and I was like, something is missing. So I have decided to get some plants. I think the green in the plants just pops so nicely with the black. So we did find this little local nursery and get a few different plants, but I don't know much about plants again, so I'm going to take care of them really nicely. So I've put on my calendar, every Wednesday I water my plants, so that's on the task. I did get one pot planter from IKEA to place the plant that is all the way up in the corner over there. And for the other ones, it's really cool because our loft has those pipes that we can actually hang stuff on it. We checked and the pipes are like strong enough, so it's not gonna break or anything. So we just hooked one plant right there and I think it just ties the whole place together. I love it. I'm really, really happy about this kitchen. It makes me wanna cook like every day. I'm so excited to just look at it. And you know, at the beginning I was like, this is a pretty small kitchen to cook on, but now I like that it's small because it's so easy to clean. It's literally just one swipe, I go whoop, 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 and the kitchen is clean. Even though I really wanted to make the kitchen really nice and aesthetically pleasing and all, I had to make sure it was functional. So I think I nailed it, as I've had this kitchen like after the whole makeover. I've had it for a few weeks now and I see that it's pretty functional for both of us. guys, I'm gonna leave you right here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what type of video you guys wanna see next. And let me know if you like this type of video, because I'm thinking of making another one for my living room. So just let me know. All right, you guys, don't forget to follow me at Mia Rondria on Instagram. Bye.